Amazon made an exciting announcement on Friday, revealing their plans to acquire three Falcon 9 rocket launches from SpaceX. These launches, scheduled to commence in mid-2025, will play a crucial role in deploying Amazon's network of Kuiper Internet satellites. In their statement, Amazon expressed their enthusiasm for the additional capacity that the SpaceX launches will bring, as they aim to supplement their existing launch contracts and support the smooth execution of Project Kuiper's satellite deployment schedule. It's worth noting that SpaceX, with its impressive fleet of over 5,100 Starlink spacecraft currently orbiting the Earth, is a formidable competitor to Amazon in the broadband satellite arena. In the previous year, Amazon made a significant move by acquiring the majority of the Western world's surplus launch capacity, excluding SpaceX. This strategic move allowed them to secure an impressive 68 rocket flights from renowned companies like United Launch Alliance, Arianespace, and Blue Origin. The purpose behind this ambitious endeavor was to deploy thousands of satellites for their groundbreaking Kuiper broadband network. Prior to this, Amazon had already partnered with ULA for 9 Atlas V launches, which played a crucial role in supporting the initial series of Kuiper launches. The first of these launches took place in October, successfully deploying Amazon's first two Kuiper prototype satellites. Looking ahead, we can expect more Atlas V rockets to take off next year, carrying operational Kuiper satellites into space. Amazon's vision for a global broadband network is truly taking flight. Amazon's decision to exclude SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket from its rocket purchase has caused quite a stir. Shareholders of a pension fund that includes Amazon stock filed a lawsuit in August, claiming that Amazon, Jeff Bezos, and its board of directors breached their fiduciary duty by not considering SpaceX during the launch service procurement. While Amazon will rely on the Atlas V to launch its first batches of satellites, none of the rockets needed to deploy the Kuiper network have flown. The Falcon 9 rocket is the only rocket, with any openings in its launch schedule, that could make up for delays caused by Amazon's other launch providers. SpaceX has launched an impressive 89 Falcon 9, or Falcon Heavy rockets, so far this year and plans to increase the launch cadence to one flight every 2.5 days in 2024. Most of these launches are for SpaceX's own Starlink internet network. According to the lawsuit, Amazon's decision to exclude the Falcon 9 rocket last year was driven by a fierce and personal rivalry between Elon Musk, the founder of SpaceX, and Bezos. However, it seems that this rivalry has taken a backseat, as Amazon now finds itself in need of assistance from SpaceX. SpaceX is the only other Western company that has a reliable spacecraft in operation. In simple terms, Kuiper had no other viable options, explained Caleb Henry, the director of research at Quilty Space. Amazon's Kuiper network is set to revolutionize the way we access broadband services. With a first-generation architecture, consisting of 3,236 satellites orbiting at a low Earth altitude, customers across the globe will soon enjoy high-speed connectivity. However, there's a tight deadline looming for Amazon. They need to deploy half of these satellites by July 2026 to maintain network authorization from the Federal Communications Commission. To meet this ambitious target, Amazon will have to launch at least 2 satellites per month starting next year. The number of satellites per launch will depend on the lift capacity of the rockets they use. The Vulcan rocket, contracted for 38 Kuiper launches, is scheduled for its first test flight on December 24 from Cape Canaveral, Florida. Meanwhile, Europe's Ariane 6 rocket, planned for 18 launches, is set to make its inaugural flight in mid-2024. And let's not forget about the New Glenn from Blue Origin, owned by Amazon's founder Jeff Bezos. While it may debut towards the end of 2024, Amazon has already booked 12 New Glenn missions, with an option for 15 more. However, there have been delays in the debut of all three rockets, pushing back Amazon's plans by at least a year. This puts even more pressure on Amazon to meet their Kuiper schedule. Despite the challenges, Amazon remains committed to bringing reliable broadband service to the world, and they are determined to overcome any obstacles that come their way. According to Henry, if all the rockets are launched successfully on their current schedules, ULA, Arianespace, and Blue Origin will have to increase their launch rates quickly to meet Amazon's demand. This will require a series of successful flights, which can be challenging as new rockets often fail on early test flights. The pressure will be on ULA and its Vulcan rocket to perform. Henry also mentioned that achieving a steady launch cadence is just as difficult, if not more so, than achieving a debut flight. Amazon needs to consider not only when new vehicles will reach the launch pad, but also how quickly they can be launched again. Amazon is investing in ULA's expansion at its Florida launch base, which will double the company's launch capacity. The investment, totaling about $2 billion, will fund upgrades at Cape Canaveral, including a second vertical hangar and mobile launch platform for Vulcan rockets. With dual lanes for launch processing, ULA hopes to fly up to 25 Vulcan rockets per year. The company is also expanding factory space to produce more Vulcan engines, solid rocket boosters, and payload fairings for Kuiper missions. Amazon and ULA officials are optimistic that these investments will prevent the Vulcan rocket from experiencing the same growing pains as other launch vehicles. If Amazon wants to deploy over 1,600 Kuiper satellites by mid-2026, they need to ensure that the spacecraft can be launched using a variety of vehicles. Amazon, based in Kirkland, Washington, has intentionally designed the Kuiper satellites to be compatible with different launch providers. In fact, an Amazon official mentioned that the company is open to signing contracts with other launch providers, indicating their eagerness for more launch opportunities. Interestingly, the official also pointed out that SpaceX's Falcon 9 is not capable of carrying as many Kuiper satellites in a single flight compared to ULA's Vulcan. Among the satellite megaconstellations being developed to offer high-speed broadband connectivity to consumers, governments, and corporate customers worldwide, Amazon's Project Kuiper is a significant player. However, SpaceX's Starlink currently holds the title for the largest constellation, while OneWeb and Starlink are the two low-Earth orbit constellations currently providing commercial internet service. Once again, SpaceX has demonstrated its willingness to accept funds from its rivals in order to launch their satellites. OneWeb, after losing access to Russian rockets due to Russia's invasion of Ukraine, sought the assistance of SpaceX to deploy its broadband satellites. In a similar vein, other competitors of Starlink, such as Viasat and SES, have also chosen to launch their spacecraft using SpaceX rockets. In a separate collaboration, Northrop Grumman has enlisted SpaceX's services to launch three of its Cygnus supply freighters to the International Space Station. This decision comes as Northrop Grumman redesigns its own rocket, the Antares, by replacing Russian engines with engines made in the United States. Notably, Northrop Grumman and SpaceX employ distinct systems to transport cargo to the International Space Station. That's it for today's episode. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Please let us know what you think in the comments section down below. Your feedback is very important to us, because it helps us make better videos for you, so thank you very much and we hope to see you again next time.